Come on, we don't have any time. Take my hand. I need to rescue you from the dark ages of self-fracture. Because now we have a new way to do self-fracture procedurally with geometry nodes. Let me explain. So this is going to be using the new version of Blender. If you don't have the 3.3 alpha at the time of recording, this isn't going to work because it's using a new node. So self-fracture procedurally. How? Geometry nodes. Make a geonodes thing on the cube, and we're going to be using this new node. It is kind of the key insight. Volume cube. What this is it's a cube that's a volume. And you're like, how in the heck is this going to give us a self-fracture? Well, let's look at the settings. We can control the size of the cube in any axis, any direction. We can control the density of it, how intense it is, and the resolution of it, how like voxelized it is. Here's how we're going to use that information. For the density, we can actually plug in any field like a noise texture, and you can see it's kind of getting a bit cloudy. More specifically, we can plug in a Voronoi texture. Take this, set it to distance to edge, is what I found, and I'm going to bring down the scale. You can almost see that it's kind of separating it into fragments, but in case you can't see that, we're going to take this and take the volume and bring it back into a mesh. And boom, you can see we've fragmented the thing. What this is doing is it has the volume cube having a volume of Voronoi. What Voronoi is it is fragmentation. It's scattering a bunch of points in our volume and telling us how close are we to those points. In other words, separate it into fragments. If you don't understand it, it's fine. But when we turn it back into a mesh, you can see now we have these pieces. Can we control them? Yeah, we can control the randomness. We can get different distributions with the W slider, and we can make these higher res by taking our resolution and like bumping it. Let's not go too high, but we can also make these fragments kind of bigger in a sense. Like we can have them take up the whole mesh. So I'm just going to add just the correct value. It should be 0.1 because the threshold's 0.1. So you take that and you go a tiny bit below, let's say 0.09. And now you've self-fractured a cube. Let me take this and show you a couple examples of what we can do with this. So we can scale elements, which is a node that lets us scale individual islands. So as long as they're separate, they'll scale. And you can see, oh, now it's all scaling together. We got to get a bit more break room, or you could change the threshold. Let's see. There we go. This lets us scale the individual pieces. One cool thing about this can also be driven by a node. So I'm going to use this gradient texture, and I'm going to add, which lets me, let's look at it from the x-axis, since this is what it's using, lets us control the size of these fragments, and we can add more of those. Let's make this smaller. It's a bit of a balancing act right now until you make a function for the resolution, but you can see these fragments are now getting scaled depending on the x-axis. So this is already a cool render in its own right, and you can have things form. But I know what you're thinking. Okay, we have a cube, and it's, you know, it's doing a thing. How do we fragment anything else? So it turns out we can, and it's actually any mesh, like a Suzanne, a transformer, any model you make, which is something I figured out recently, a couple minutes ago. So let's say we wanted to turn this into a fragmentation of the UV sphere. Basically, what we need to do is the same idea with the density and the Voronoi texture, but it somehow needs to know the volume of the sphere, not the cube. So in some sense, we need to plug this into the density, which we can't do. Here's how we do it. Use a geometry proximity node, which seems to work in 3D. Do it like this, take the distance, plug it into the density. What you can see this is doing, you can almost see there's this shell, and we can make that a bit more intense with a multiplication. You can almost see there's this spherical shell that is showing us where the sphere is. For a bit of processing, you could throw this through a less. I am clicking everything other than less than. Throw it through a less than, and less than zero, or something slightly above or below zero, will give us the shape. Let's send this through volume to mesh. You can see it's very fragmented. You can kind of fix that by adding a bit of room there. Scale elements, and to get this to be fractured, you now take the shape and you multiply it with our Voronoi. And you can see the sphere is open because we set it up with that gradient from before. But you can see we've now fractured. Let me just show you the raw thing. We've now fractured a sphere procedurally. Again, if I want the different fracture, boom, there's a different one. And we can have smaller segments, bigger segments, whatever. If you wanted a custom mesh, so again, this is, it's kind of like a bit theoretical. You can make some cool renders out of this, but you know, it's obviously not as clean as cell fracture currently. But what you can do is instead of a sphere, you can use an arbitrary object. So I'm just going to use Suzanne since I feel like that's the obvious example. Object info node, take a Suzanne, and you can kind of see it's there. You either want to make sure the cube that we have is bigger. How do we want to do this? Do we want to increase this? There we go. Either want to make sure the volume cube's bigger than the object you're using, or you can scale down Suzanne so it fits inside the volume of the cube. But you can see now we have a fragmented Suzanne. This is something that would look better with a higher resolution, which is costly to compute, but there you go. So, you know, use this for whatever you want. I feel like kind of the cleanest way to do this is maybe just use a raw cube thing, which is taking a second to load. I'm going to bring down the resolution here. This is probably the simplest use case, but it is a cool use case. Why is this not showing scale elements? So yeah, I just wanted to let you know that cell fracture is a thing. Cool, right? Okay, let's wrap this tutorial up. So, by the way, check this out. I got a new GoPro rig. It's not filming you guys. It's okay. I'm not secretly filming you. Thank you for watching the tutorial to completion. And as always, I like to end these tutorials by promoting the ever-living GoPro, not sponsored, out of my Patreon at the end of this. So, as always, there's a link in the description for Patreon. Three reasons to join other than the fact that maybe you just like these tutorials and you want to keep them available for everybody for free, which I appreciate to the 700 or 800 people that are doing that. Three reasons to join the Patreon. One, early access to tutorials. You could have seen this video early, I think 2 days early for this one. That's just a thing. Second of all, blend files. So I'm going to make this thing a demo blend file that you can just download. You don't have to make it yourself. And any blend file I've made over the last 3 years since 2019, also available. Thirdly, we have exclusive tutorials, which I make every once in a while, but there's a bit of a catalog now since I've been at it for a couple months. You could watch tutorials that are only available to the patrons. Either way, I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something. And thank you for watching, and thank you for making it all the way to the end. Seriously.